So welcome once again to Sami and Mathematics, and it's another interesting topic. We call it rational functions. I've done a series of videos and students keep asking me, what do you mean by a rational function? Because I keep making that statement. So actually, in this video, I want to actually describe a rational function. I probably solve any question, I may not. A rational function is a function that looks like this. P of x equals to f of x divided by g of x. The more like a quotient, more like an upstair and a downstair function, where f of x and g of x may be polynomials. Interestingly, it's always okay when they are polynomials, but may not be polynomials all the time. But generally, f of x can be considered as a polynomial. And g of x also considered as a polynomial. But interestingly, g of x should not be zero, because division by zero is not permitted in mathematics. If you divide anything by zero in mathematics, we say it is undefined. It's actually undefined. So if g of x is actually equals to zero, then we have p of x to be equals to f of x divided by zero, and that's very sad. But in this case, I'm going to put g of x as this, knowing that it's already zero here. So in this case, it becomes what we say in mathematics, undefined. Undefined. Now the question is, there is a particular value that makes this undefined. There's a particular value, and that is the value of x. So if you put x as a, and it substitutes in g of x and it gives you zero, we say that a, in mathematics, we say that a is the point, a is the point of discontinuity. So a is called the point of discontinuity. That's what we call a. That's the point where P of A will be equal to F of A over G of A. And G of A being zero, this becomes undefined. Undefined. So, another interesting thing about a rational function is that it is preferable that the denominator is smaller in, is higher in degree. This is what I mean. For example, if we have f of x equals to 2x plus 5 over x squared plus 5x plus 6. There's an interesting question they ask junior students, grade 12 students, 3 students. They ask them, for which value will this function be undefined? All you need to do is just to equate this x squared plus 5x plus 6 to zero, and that gives you a quadratic equation. Solving this quadratic equation, you will see that your x will be equals to minus 3 and your x will be equals to minus 2. These 2 points, minus 3 and minus 2, are the point of discontinuity. They are the values for which f of x is undefined. So f of x is undefined at x equals to minus 3 and x equals to minus 2. So there are so many things concerning rational function. You can also find the limit of rational function. You can also like limit of 1 over x minus 2 as x tends to 2. You see, this is going to be equal to infinity. Why? Because 1 over 0, the limit of 1 over x minus 2 as x tends to 2 is actually what? Infinity. But the function here, 1 over x minus 2, is not defined at the point x equals to 2. Not defined at this point. But when we find the limit at x tends to 2, it's going to be equal to infinity. So many things about rational functions. In one of my videos, I'm going to be talking about graphing rational functions. Thank you very much. Remember to like and share.